Hey, what's up, guys? My name is Josue. Welcome back to La Vida Josue. So today, one of my good friends is gonna get married. So it's gonna be an exciting day. It's cold outside, but we got a big day ahead of us. So actually yesterday, you know, there's gonna be a beach house party after the ceremony. So we spent some time decorating it, putting up some decorations for the after party after the ceremony. So the ceremony is gonna be like a private event, and then everyone's gonna come out later on to the beach house. So it's a vlog for you guys. I'm gonna go ahead and, you know, try to record as much of it as I can. Spoiler alert, there's gonna be no footage of the ceremony itself, so it's just gonna be like everything leading up to it and then everything after it. So stick around, watch this video. Nothing is planned, no shots or nothing, so we're just going with it. So I'm heading to the church where the ceremony is going to be held later, which is in Suffolk, Virginia. It's about like 40 minutes away from where I live. So we're about to coast for a little bit. It's a little gloomy outside. It's kind of cold. Not as cold as last night, but yeah, it's going to be a good day. To the church right now, and the ceremony's not until later, is because we're gonna do a rehearsal and, you know, make sure that everybody knows what they're doing before the actual wedding takes place. So we have to be at the church at 10 a.m. sharp. It's 9:10 right now, and so my friend Josh, that's who's getting married, so he just texted the group like, yo, make sure you know, see you there, fellas. And I just texted him, yo, I just woke up, and I gotta try to make him shit himself a little bit, you know, before the big moment. Update on the prank. I told Josh that I was running late and that I was just leaving my house now, so hopefully I can get a good reaction. Unless they may be on to me, to be honest, but we'll find out. All right, so just got to the church. I think Josh is on to us. I think he knows that we're messing with him, so I don't know. I don't even know if he's here because I don't see his car, but I'm gonna go inside, see if I can get a reaction. Well, don't you look at that. I actually beat him. Look who's pulling up behind me, baby. Ah, you sack of shit. What up, though? What's up, son?
Yeah, you got me.
I know I did.
I was like, I ain't gonna let it bother me.
Dude, I was like, oh my God, I wanted to see what the fuck I can do to make him shit his pants. All right, so we just got to the room here where we're all gonna be getting ready. Some chairs, oh, a couple of flower things. By the way, I might have failed to mention that I'm one of the groomsmen, which is why I'm here for the rehearsal. There's all my stuff.
By the way, drop down in the comments and let me know, is it offensive to film in the church? I didn't ask for permission, but I'm just filming right now. So let me know if this is something that, you know, you guys take offense to, because if you do, you know, I won't do it again, but I'm doing it for this video.
We got Zephan in the house.
Oh my God, he's already vlogging.
We got Henry.
Took him 30 seconds to start vlogging.
My vow book.
I haven't been in church.
Oh, you wrote vows?
Yeah.
Oh, we didn't know if they were there.
Aren't you supposed to?
Some people don't. Some people just get them written.
I love you, and I'll love you some more tomorrow.
My ring?
I love you.
Yeah. Oh, that's sick.
Keep in the black.
Are you giving a speech?
No, we're not. Because
he told us no.
I didn't say no. We were like, when we talked, you were like,
dude, you said no.
Don't, no. You make it
up. So I wasted a speech?
No, you can give a speech.
I can give a speech.
I made myself frozen. You know what I lost?
Alright, so we're doing a rehearsal right now. We're standing in formation. Say hello to everybody.
She's already crying, dude. Hey, you're all spun up.
Alright, so we just ran through the rehearsal. We're back in the room. Oh my God, how you feeling, buddy? Look at this gentleman. Look how beautiful this guy is. Dude, you look good.
Hey,
are you
Josh,
ready, son?
Are these the rings?
I'm not gonna lie, Josh. I don't think I have my part down all the way. This is gonna be sick, my God.
I'm gonna de-dress too now.
Is that, are we doing that now?
No, okay, so this is how this goes.
I know, you put these on the inside.
I'm gonna drink tons of coffee.
You put these on the inside.
Alright,
I'm gonna tell everybody to do this.
Okay.
She really cried?
Yeah, it looks fine.
Are you serious?
We manage a lot of the stuff he does. Yeah.
There we go.
One of our agents is like,
okay, man of the hour. Okay, bye.
Hey.
Yeah. Okay, Leonardo DiCaprio's son.
Hey. Bye. Folder there, making sure we don't see these.
loose edges. What's in your pocket?
Don't even want to.
So I paid.
Alright, so we gotta use the put these guys on.
Yeah, now you're gonna feel like your pants are up your ass.
They were definitely up my ass.
That's when it touches.
Alright, about to head out with these homies. We'll see you guys after the ceremony. Peace.
Alright guys, so the reception went well. I mean, good times, good vibes. Congratulations to Josh and Jenna. So we did the ceremony, we took some photos, we got some food, we took some more photos, and we just changed. It's about 3:44 now. There's the after party at the beach house, but we're gonna go ahead and go to our friend Henry's house first. We're gonna stop there to, I guess, just hang out a little bit, and then we're gonna go to the beach house.
That shot glass is like a little beaker.
Yeah, this is a chemistry beaker.
I mean, you
beaker.
Also don't have to measure my shot out.
I was just trying to show you proof that,
you
like, this is it.
You pour it straight in my mouth if you want.
It's okay.
It's baby bird vodka, or baby bird tequila too, shy.
Because you know what I really enjoy? Just lingering flavor of tequila in
It's tequila. It's tequila.
All right, guys. Cheers to Josh.
Also cheers, yeah. Josh and Jenna.
Yeah, happy happiness and other stuff. I'm taking mine. Yeah, okay, I can't put the camera on.
The first night, you should have driven my car and I'll let you.
Classic host.
Okay, so.
Round dose. Oh, wait, no, round three, though.
Round three.
He's like, damn, party even started.
You guys,
I'm still on.
It's crazy. There's a lot of people, and this isn't even like the tip of the iceberg yet.
Beautiful girl, Jenna. You came into my life at a time I wasn't even expecting someone. You turned my world upside down for the better. I never knew it was possible to fall in love as hard and as fast as I did on that late spring day. As cliche as it sounds, I truly never knew what love meant until I had the opportunity to say it to you. These three words have grown every single day since then and will continue to grow for all eternity. Looking back at our relationship, I realize how much you make me a better person and how much I need you to conquer life with. We've had our shares of good and bad days, and every single thing has made us stronger than ever. Thank you for loving me, teaching me, helping me, encouraging me, and putting me where I am now. Jenna, it's impossible for me to put into words the infinite embrace you have on my heart. God created you for me, and therefore I will honor you both for the rest of my life with the following vows. I vow to wake up every morning and thank God that he gave me you, to look around and appreciate everything we have together, especially all the critters you bring home. I vow to put your needs before my own. I will sit back and listen to you with compassion and understanding and speak to you with encouragement. I vow to take initiative with everyday tasks in our marriage, even if that means I cook and do the dishes. You make me want to be the best I can be, and I promise to always support you and be your rock in return. No matter the time or place, I will always be there as a hand to hold, a shoulder to lean on, or thighs to keep your feet warm. I vow to constantly ensure we are growing together and capable of achieving every goal and dream we have. I promise to always pick you up if you've fallen and to lift you up even when you're at your highest peaks. I vow to keep our space together clean. As much as I am a pack rat, I'll always make sure the clutter is at a minimum. I vow to always trust you and respect you, laugh with you and cry with you, regardless of anything else happening in the world. I promise to always be faithful and honest to you and our marriage together, unless dinner isn't tasty one night. I vow to always be your best friend, to spend the rest of our life together like it's the first summer we met, to never become complacent or get bored. We'll always be planning our next adventure together. I promise to respect you as a whole person with your own interests, needs, languages, and desires, and to realize that those are different but no less important than my own. I vow to love you for the rest of my life, to provide you with everything you deserve, and to never lose sight of the things that made us so strong. I love you, Jenna.